Hello guys, and welcome to Salesforce Drillers. So in our previous videos, we have seen how we can set up the cluster on Kubernetes using KOps, and we have also set up the Kubernetes dashboard in our previous videos. So if you guys want to know how to set up the cluster and how to set up the Kubernetes dashboard, so please refer to the previous videos. Now in these videos, let us have a look on the resources that are created when we created our cluster. So this is our EC2 console. So as we can see, it has created a master server, or I can say a master node, and three worker nodes. As we have executed this in the kops create cluster command. So along with this, if I'll show you the security groups, it has also created the security groups for master, for nodes, and for the dashboard. And let us have a look on the auto scaling. And in the auto scaling too, it has created two auto scaling groups. One is for master node and the another one is for our worker nodes. That is here. So these all the things it has created. Let us have a look on the load balancers too. It might have also created a load balancer for our master server. So yes, here it is, load balancer for our master. And it has also created a VPC for the Kubernetes cluster where Kubernetes perform all its operations. So if I'll show you in VPC, so yes, here it is, Salesforce Drillers create as .local. So these are the resources that are created by the Kubernetes when we created the cluster. So let us have a look whether it is self-healing or not. So let us terminate an EC2 instance forcefully and see whether a new instance will come up or not. So let us terminate this last instance. So I'll go to action, I'll go to state settings, instance settings, and then I'll go to terminate. I'll go to instance state and then I'll click on terminate. And let us wait for the time till it's get completely shut down. And it should again create an another node server, or I can say another worker node on its own. That is why it is said that Kubernetes is self-healing. So till it get completely shut down, let us have a look. So these were the steps that we have covered in our cluster creation videos, and along with the dashboard creation, in which we have also generated the admin password and token for our Kubernetes dashboard. So I hope that those videos will be clear to you if you have referred to those videos, and if you have not referred to those videos yet, then please refer to those videos. And for knowing about AWS CLI and how we can create users, so for that please refer to the Learn AWS section in Salesforce Drillers. You will be getting all those steps from there very, very clearly, because it is a prerequisite that for being a DevOps, you should have your hands on any other cloud provider. Not necessarily with AWS, it could be Azure or Google Cloud also. So let us see whether it is terminated or not. Since it is still terminating, still in a shutdown state, so we will wait till it goes shutdown. Till let us have a look on the website. So in our previous videos, we have covered about Kubernetes, about architecture, and how we can set up the clusters. So please refer to the previous videos, and as I told you that before proceeding to Kubernetes, you should have knowledge on Docker. So it is a prerequisite that you should have knowledge on Docker first, then only you will be able to grab the things in Kubernetes, because without knowing Docker, you won't be able to understand what Kubernetes is. So in our previous videos, we have covered all these steps. We have also gone through the Kubernetes architecture. So please refer to the videos. So let us have a look. Let us see. Yes, so as we can see, it has terminated completely. Now it should again, now Kubernetes should again start an EC2 instance. So let us refresh it. Earlier we were having one master and three worker nodes, from which one worker node we have terminated. Now another worker node should be up within a moment, within a while. as we can see, yes, another worker node is coming up. As we can see, it is in a pending state, and soon it will be in running state. So as we have seen, that does that how it is called self-healing, because when we have terminated an instance forcefully, it has again started a new EC2 instance, or I can see it has again started a new worker node. So that is what Kubernetes is. That is why it is said that Kubernetes is self-healing. Yes, as we can see, this particular instance is in running state, and soon it will join our Kubernetes cluster on its own. So these were the resources that Kubernetes has set up when we have created the clusters. So in our next video, we will go through the deployment processes in Kubernetes. So thank you, guys.